What's up, guys? Mike here, the Detroit Borg, with a quick look at what's new with the 6th beta of iOS 11. And as always, we get yet more visual changes. One of them is the new Maps icon, which reflects the new location of the Apple Park campus. So that new spaceship campus that we've heard a lot about, we actually get a map icon that's been updated for that location. So that's kind of interesting. We also get a new App Store icon. So this is the second iteration within the iOS 11 beta. So they keep changing even the things they've been changing already. This time it's much more abstracted. So although it still looks like the stylized A, it no longer incorporates the tools of the previous design. In fact, it kind of looks like a pile of popsicle sticks. They've also fixed the Reminders app icon, so the bullet points read from the left to the right rather than reverse. Another icon that gets a visual tweak is the clock icon, which now gets bolder numbers. And that's pretty much the theme of iOS 11, much more contrast so things stand out. One of my favorite new features for the 6th beta is the new AirPods animation. So when you open up your AirPods, you now see a 3D representation of those components right on your screen. Now, if you remember from the 5th beta, we got this little indicator in the upper right corner of the media control widget. That indicated that there were other devices nearby that we could connect to, like Bluetooth headphones or AirPlay devices like an Apple TV. But this time, if you connect to those devices, it actually pulsates in blue, just to let you know that your media is currently being broadcast or played on another device. Another tweak from a 5th beta feature is the new calling sound for FaceTime, which has been sped up. So although we got the new tone from the last release, it's now faster, so the intervals aren't quite as far apart. Speaking of FaceTime, another feature that debuted with the 5th beta is FaceTime Photographs. Previously, I used to use the screen grab feature, but now you can actually take photographs right from the FaceTime app. Now, if you're a fan of the Betafish live wallpapers from the original iPhone 6S, you're going to be sad to see that they've been taken out of this version of iOS 11, so we're not sure if they're coming back or if new ones are coming in. And because iOS 11 really likes informational splash pages, we get another new one for the Photos app. All the brightness has also been moved from display and brightness to display accommodations in accessibility. So I'm not sure why that is. That may change before we see the final release. Apple keeps tweaking the unlock effect, so this time they sort of combine two visual effects, a swipe up of the lock screen and a zoom out of the home screen. So it sort of combines into this one overall effect that's very distinctive to the unlock effect. By the way, I post previews of the new betas every time they're released, so make sure you follow me on Twitter and Instagram to get a first look before the final video comes out on YouTube. Alrighty guys, that's going to do for me in this quick look at the 6th beta, but of course, if you see something in the 6th beta that I missed, please let me know in the comment section below, and I'll see you again in my next video.